winter, and my dad kept in a barn. He'd take it out and we'd drive it around on the farm. Back through those fields where the trees smelled like pine, we'd drive around for hours and that sun would always shine. And my dad asked me if I'd like to take the wheel. I'd always remember that moment and how good it made me feel. And we'd drive down Freedom Road. I'd push that throttle forward just as fast as it would go. I remember my dad saying, just take it slow. We'd carry a heavy load, driving down Freedom Road. A few years later, I was 16 when my dad bought our first truck. That old Ford was powerful, and it was worth every buck. And my dad would tell me, let's go pick up some stones, and we'd take them to a big ravine. It was our own private dump. As I took the wheel, the past came back. Driving down Freedom Road. You can get there in anything, in a tractor, truck, or car. Freedom Road could be anywhere, even in your own backyard. And you can drive down Freedom Road. You can drive for miles and miles. It doesn't matter how far you go. If you want some advice, just take it slow.
Country music's brightest stars gathered Sunday night at the World's Fair Amphitheater. T.G. Shepherd, Tammy Wynette, and Eddie Rabbit kept the stage rocking with the hits their fans had come to hear. But the night was also special for 8-year-old Jason Ellsworth. Born 3 months premature, Jason was left blind and stricken with cerebral palsy. Despite his physical limits, Jason is a survivor, a little boy who only wants to make others happy. He did that last night, and with a little help from his newfound friends, Jason stole the show.
Make it one every day. Oh, my,
Jason has been playing the piano since the ripe old age of 18 months. He's one of 600,000 special children nationwide who participate in programs sponsored by the National Committee Arts for the Handicapped. 200 other children involved with the program were in attendance as special guests of the performers. Like most other big names, after his performance, Jason threw a press conference.
Did you think when you were coming down in New Orleans for this trip that you'd be singing with these three great country music stars?
Yes.
You did? You did?
He knew what he was going to do, yeah. Didn't he? Yeah.
What do you want to be when you grow up, Jason?
Cowboy.
A cowboy.
A cowboy.
Why is that?
A singing cowboy?
Yep. Well, because cowboys are Western.
You going to be a singing cowboy like Roy Rogers, maybe?
Yes. He yodels, too.
Can you yodel a little for us?
Yeah. Ole, ole, ole.
We live in a world where stardom comes and goes, but every once in a while you run across someone who, day after day, lives up to that title without even trying. Yes, Jason, you are a star. Wear that title well, because you, young man, have earned it. Paul Murphy at the fair.
This is little Jason Ellsworth. We heard him yesterday, and he's terrific. Hi, Jason. Yeah, let's go over here. How you doing, guys? Sure. Somebody take this microphone. We've been fortunate enough to meet all the people involved with the National Committee. And while I get Jason in place, I just want to say that if you have anything you'd like to give, or any support you'd like to give, send whatever you can to the National Committee Arts with a Handicapped. They could use it. Now, Jason, how you feeling?
Great.
Great? Are you a little nervous?
No.
No? This is Jason's first time ever on stage. He's making his debut. His debut right here in New Orleans. So why don't you give him a nice round of applause, and we're going to give him a song.
Thank you.
What would you like to sing, Jason?
Oh, yeah. Mom, I got some blues.
Is it okay to teach you, Tammy, and I help you out with some background singing? Yeah?
Yep.
Okay, great. Take it away.
But believe it was just something that's
Jason, I think you're a hit. Isn't that great, Jason? And a special moment for us yesterday. I'm sure it was for you tonight. Gigi, Tammy, thanks again. Jason, thank you. Do you have anything you want to say to everybody before you leave?
As you get off of Interstate 95, there's a place where the ocean comes alive. The salty air and a gentle warm breeze. Somehow it put my mind at ease. Then we walk into an old seaport. French fries frying in the food court. And we'd see those old ships shining from afar, glistening like the brightest star. Down in Mystic, where the sailors sing their songs about the sea. Down in Mystic, where an old foghorn would call out a melody. And the ocean waves put my mind at ease. Now I'm lying in my bed at night and dreaming about those mystic memories. Where the seagulls cry and the ships creak and moan. Somehow always brought me home. I can't describe the feelings that I had. Some were happy, some were scary, and some were sad. Down in Mystic, where the sailors sing their songs about the sea. Down in Mystic, where an old foghorn would call out a melody. And the ocean waves put my mind at ease. Now I'm lying in my bed at night and dreaming about those mystic memories. Just a little child, I look back on those times and I smile. 'Cause I'm down in Mystic, where the sailors sing their songs about the sea. Down in Mystic, where an old foghorn would call out a melody. And the ocean waves put my mind at ease. Now I'm lying in my bed at night and dreaming about those mystic memories. Those mystic memories. As you get off of Interstate 95, there's a place where the ocean comes alive.
White House with the Gatlin Brothers is all in a day's work for 9-year-old Grand Ole Opry veteran Jason Ellsworth, who copes with cerebral palsy. Asked about his plans, he's nothing if not ambitious.
Not give up work. They're right. They're right about me being blind. But that doesn't mean that I can't do stuff that they can't do.
The show will appear as a PBS special later this year. At the White House, Peter Quinhakis Entertainment tonight.
Always be positive. My 5-year-old hesitated and said, all right, I'm positive, I'm not going to catch anything. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to introduce a very special person, a very special friend, the founder of the very special arts program, Mrs. Jean Kennedy Smith. Jean?
Thank you, Cliff. On behalf of the National Committee, Arts with the Handicapped, I would like to take this opportunity to thank Mrs. Reagan for inviting us here today to celebrate the artistic accomplishments of some very extraordinary people. One such person is our next guest. Just 9 years old, he has performed at our Connecticut Very Special Arts Festival, at our national festival held last year at the Kennedy Center, at the World's Fair, and the Grand Ole Opry in Nashville, where he received a standing ovation. All of this would not have been possible without the love and support of his family, especially his mother, who is with us today. Mrs. Ellsworth, would you stand? Mrs. Ellsworth has said of her son, "I do believe Jason was put here for a purpose, and because he is so loving, he brings out the best in people. And so I am delighted to introduce this exceptional, talented, unique, and loving human being, Jason Ellsworth, who will perform with Larry Gatlin and the Gatlin Brothers." Jason.
Thank you. I'd just like to say that I'm very delighted to be here, Inspired 85. And this first song I would like to dedicate is a song sung by Hank Williams, who sings this song. It's called "Long Gone Lonesome Blues."
Sing better than I do. I make a living doing this. Jason, we, on behalf of Steve and Reed and I, we would like to invite you, since you did so well singing that song by Hank Williams, now we want you to sing "All the Gold in California" with us. Will you do that?
Yep.
For these nice folks? You will. Are you sure we want to talk you into it? Okay, give me a G chord. Ready? One.
We're
going
to sing
"All the Gold in California." Is in a bank in the middle of Beverly Hills, in somebody else's name. So if you're dreaming about California, it don't matter at all where you played before. California's brand new. May I borrow your mic there? Thank you, Jason. Trying to be a hero, winding up a zero, can scar a man forever. Yeah, you can sing along. Right down to your soul. Living on the spotlight can kill a man outright. 'Cause everything that glitters is not gold. Come back in there, you go. And all the gold in California is in a bank in the middle of Beverly Hills. It's somebody else's name. So if you're dreaming about California, it don't matter at all where you played before. California's a brand new.
I think we can get the folks to sing with us. We're gonna change keys. Y'all sing it now.
All the gold. They know this, Jason. In California.
This is a hit, Jason. They don't even know this song.
It's somebody else's name. So if you're dreaming,
James Brady knows
about California. It don't matter at all where you played before. California's a brand new game.
Big finish now, Jason.
A brand new
boy, Jason Ellsworth. All right, pal. Hey. That's my boy, Jason Ellsworth. All right, pal. Hey.
Well, welcome, everybody. But first of all, thank you so much for the lovely painting. I appreciate it very much. It's beautiful, and I'll treasure it. But thank you all for the entertainment. If anybody got through that entertainment with a dry eye, they did better than I. So I do thank you. It was wonderful. The songs, everything.
Cool. 8 minutes before nine right now, there's a new star on the country western music scene right now. His name is Jason Ellsworth. He's nine. Jason's a very special young man, very special young performer. He's been blind since he was born and has cerebral palsy. 2 days ago, he sang and played piano with the Gatlin brothers at the White House. In case you missed it on the news, here's some videotape.
A man needs a woman that he can lean on. For my leader, put him on, they come and out to us. She's a love.
Good job. We've decided we're going to get him a shaving kit and some extra jeans and take him on the road with us. You know?
Oh, no.
Oh, no, you're not. Well, okay.
Jason and his mom, Sue Ellsworth, this morning. Jason, morning. What? The Gatlin brothers make you an offer like that? Going to take you on the road? You're not going to go? How come?
Well, I thought that shaving kit was only for grown-ups.
Well, you're going to be there very soon, Jason, and you're going to need it, whether you know it or not. Hey, would that be fun, though, Jason, to go out, if even for maybe just a short time, with the Gatlin brothers?
Yeah, with them.
Yeah, with them would be all right. What was the best part of that day yesterday at the White House?
Meeting Jermaine Jackson.
Why is that? You a fan?
Well, he's black and, you know, I like black people.
Why is that?
Well, I don't know. I just like the way they act.
Jason, you were also down at Grand Ole Opry and sang with, what, Tammy Wynette and Eddie Rabbit?
That was in New Orleans.
That was New Orleans. Of all these experiences between Grand Ole Opry, White House, and so forth, what's the best one? What's your favorite of the bunch?
I think New Orleans was the best.
Why is that?
Well, I can't tell which is which. I think the two ones that are the best are New Orleans and the Grand Ole Opry.
I'm sure the White House would be thrilled to hear that this morning. Sue, tell me, when did he start playing?
When he was 18 months old.
18 months?
Yes.
Was he taught?
No. Everything that he does naturally. We used to sit at the piano together, and he would follow my hands along the keys and just decided that he liked the response that he was getting from the piano, so he would just sit there and play.
So this really, we're talking about special gifts here.
I believe it.
Don't I know?
All right. The very special arts program. How constructive is that for Jason and for the other youngsters?
Oh, it's wonderful, because the National Committee's Very Special Arts have given Jason wonderful opportunities to grow that he wouldn't have had otherwise, meeting people and going places. It's allowed him to be very pleased with who he is and to express who he is. I think that that's very important for all people, and I think with disabled it's especially important, because oftentimes they don't have that real feeling of being valuable and being worth anything.
Right. Sue, it's great to meet you. Jason, good to meet you. Thanks for joining us today. Glad you had fun yesterday at the White House with the guys.
Thank you. It's a pleasure being
good
here.
Good to meet you. Thanks.
I started to sing before I could talk.
We'll be back in a minute.
I've never seen the sunrise. I've never seen the sunset. I've never seen the stars in the sky. But there's more than meets the eye. I've never seen the yellow butterfly. I've never seen the eagle soar high. I've never seen an airplane flying by. But there's more than meets the eye. But I can hear the birds singing in the tree. I can feel a soft, warm summer breeze. And I can hear the buzzing of the bees. Can't you see? Can't you see? I take a walk with you by my side, and I can go for a long bike ride. And I can see all the beauty inside, 'cause there's more than meets the eye. Yes, there's more. The eye.
This is Channel 5, Fox Television in Washington, D.C. Now, America's number one primetime newscast. This is Channel 5, 10 o'clock news.
There was a very special music salute tonight for an organization called Very Special Arts. Gladys Knight and the Pips highlighted this worthy cause at the Kennedy Center, and of course, Channel 5's Chuck Conconi was there, and he's back with a report.
Oh,
Chuck?
Wonderful music.
Yeah.
Very Special Arts is a unique organization in that it provides an opportunity for people with disabilities to participate in music, dance, drama, creative writing, and the visual arts. And tonight was the music industry's first annual salute. Gladys Knight and the Pips headlined tonight's first annual Kennedy Center concert to honor Very Special Arts.
The arts are something, too, that most people have instinctively within themselves, whether it's painting or singing or dancing or acting, what have you. And that's why I think it's so wonderful, because it's a way to express oneself. And anybody can do that.
But to do it, it takes money. People paid as much as $250 each for this evening, which began with an elegant cocktail reception at the Grand Hotel. Affiliated with the Kennedy Center, Very Special Arts was founded by Gene Kennedy Smith in 1974. Its goal is to stimulate learning, and sometimes genius is discovered, as in the case of 11-year-old Jason Ellsworth.
He has real musical talent, and I mean, he started playing when he was 18 months old, which is quite incredible. So there are people like that, but it's just like, you know, the rest of us. I mean, there are some geniuses and some not, but there are people that have, I think, overcome tremendous obstacles to participate in the arts.
Jason Ellsworth has performed all across the country, including at the White House and the Grand Ole Opry. Very Special Arts is an international program also. In addition to providing artistic experiences to 1 million individuals in every state, there are affiliated programs in 40 nations around the world.
You know, Gladys Knight and the Pips have really been involved in a lot of different causes. This wonderful event at the Kennedy Center. And you know, she recorded with Dionne Warwick, Elton John, Stevie Wonder, the song for the AIDS Foundation. And
that's right.
Just
she,
a lot of good
and
stuff.
She likes kids. She says,
yeah.
It's fascinating to see these kids react to this kind of thing. Kids that you might not ever know what they had because people ignore them. And
yeah.
Now they bring things out of them, like this little kid.
Yeah.
Gladys Knight and the Pips were in concert last evening to kick off the first music industry salute to the Very Special Arts at the Kennedy Center in Washington, D.C. The benefit gala was held to raise money for the organization which provides arts programs for those with disabilities. One who has participated in Very Special Arts is 11-year-old Jason Ellsworth, who took the stage and gave the evening's headliner a run for her money.
Somewhere out there.
Blind from birth and suffering from cerebral palsy, Jason has already performed at the White House and on national television.
He inspires all of us. He's got very special courage and a very special talent. And we know that there are millions of other children that have that too. And we, as a society, should recognize it.
This talent over here is not about whether you can see or not. It's not about whether you can walk. It's not about, you know, it's about what's inside.
Where dreams come true.
Where dreams come true.
Originally financed by the Joseph P. Kennedy Jr. Foundation, the Very Special Arts now operates in all 50 states and 40 foreign countries.
A young man from East Windsor is going to make his musical debut later this week at the Kennedy Center in Washington. What makes this an extra special event for 8-year-old Jason Ellsworth is that he has cerebral palsy and he is blind. We get more on the story from Channel 3's Saida Pagan.
I went down to watch the fish swim.
country, western, pop, or rock, Jason Ellsworth can play and sing them all. He's musically gifted, and on Friday, he'll get to show off his talents at the 10th annual Very Special Arts Festival in the nation's capital.
You like country music?
Yep.
Who are your favorite stars? Musical stars.
Johnny Cash, Alabama, Oak Ridge Boys.
Jason is the youngest member of a group called the Alleluia Players. Some were born blind with cerebral palsy, just like Jason. Others have mental handicaps or other physical problems. Jason may have to struggle with some things, but with music, it's a breeze. His mother, Susan, says he started playing the piano at 18 months.
Well, he started to sing before he could talk, so I knew that music was very important to him. And he started playing the piano. Oh, he was picking out simple melodies and able to play nursery rhymes and things like that when he was about 18 months old.
Besides getting a chance to perform, Jason and his family get to participate in workshops and do some sightseeing while they're in Washington. Jason says he's not sure if music will be his career, but one thing his family and the folks at the Very Special Arts Festival are sure of is that Jason is contributing to society in a very important way by making music that makes the world sing and smile. Saida Pagan, Channel 3 Eyewitness News, East Windsor.
A remarkable young man.
New Haven.
30 WBIT.
30 News with Joanne Nesty, meteorologist Brad Field, and sports director Mike Crispino. Now, 30 News.
Good evening. Joanne Nesty's off tonight. I'm Anna Lopez. A blind 9-year-old East Windsor boy who stole everybody's heart at the White House yesterday, including First Lady Nancy Reagan, is back home tonight. Jason Ellsworth has cerebral palsy, but it makes no difference to him. He's getting set to hit the big time in the world of entertainment television and be interviewed on the network morning talk shows. Phyllis Parizek talked with a rising star from Connecticut.
This was the scene yesterday at the White House. Jason Ellsworth joined voices with Larry Gatlin of the Gatlin Brothers. The East Windsor boy is blind and has cerebral palsy, but that hasn't stopped what many think is an exceptional talent.
He's considered the local celebrity at this point. Everybody's very excited. Everybody in our whole community has provided a great deal of support for Jason and for the family.
Jason's mom, Susan, was waiting this afternoon as the school bus pulled up to drop off Jason and his sister, Betsy. This was his first day back at school since he sang in Washington, and the White House visit was very fresh in his mind.
I love that.
Any reason in particular?
Because I get to meet all the big stars, and I just love to sing in front of a lot of people.
Jason thinks his newfound notoriety is just great, but his big love is music, country and rock. What are some of his rock and roll favorites?
Heavy metal. I like Dire Straits. Dire Straits, Motley Crue, YMT, Bob Seger, Phil Collins.
And the list goes on. Jason is supposed to go to New York with his mom to appear tomorrow morning on a network news show. But Jason says he's not going without his sister. His mom says so far the whole experience has been very positive for Jason and hopefully for other disabled people. Phyllis Parizek, 30 News.
How I love those old green mountains. I long to hear that loon's lonesome call. When I'm high up on those mountains, I want to get away from it all. Those old dirt roads are lined with balsam, and the scent fills the air. Every time I'm around it, my mind don't have a care. How I love those old green mountains. I want to hear that loon's lonesome call. When I'm high up on those mountains, I want to get away from from it all. You can go down to that old white river where the water runs cold and clear, and the sound of a croaking bullfrog, well, that's music to your ears. How I love those old green mountains. I long to hear that loon a lonesome call when I'm high upon those mountains. I want to get away from it all. Oh, I want to get away from it all.
So you feel good?
Yeah, I am. I am.
Okay, cool.
Let's do it.
Wow, did I just say that?
Yeah, you did. So we're hold right and left. And I'll have you on tether. Just so you know what that feels like, I am on tether right now holding you on your right side.
Okay.
And I'm on tether on the left side.
Gotcha.
So we're gonna start moving forward. We've got nice and slow. There's nobody ahead of us.
Yes, sir.
Miles per hour.
Wow.
Which is pretty fast.
Yeah.
That felt
interesting.
A little bit of a rush.
Yeah, a little bit.
A little fear, a little excitement.
Yeah.
That's adrenaline.
Wow.
You ready to rock?
Yes, I am.
Let's do this.
And roll.
All right, moving out.
have brought a very special talent to the show that I first heard about. I saw a film clip of him, but I first heard about him through Larry Gatlin, I suppose, because the Gatlin brothers worked with him at the White House.
That's correct.
Why don't you tell us about him?
This entertainer that I have with me tonight is 9 years old. His name's Jason Ellsworth, and he's one of the most talented young men I've ever known. I met him last year for the first time when he came up here to be on our CP telethon with us. Jason has CP. He also has an impairment with his vision, and he has a great love in his heart for country music. I would say next to Ronnie Robbins and Katie Moffitt, he probably knows more about country music than anybody I know. And he's a wonderful, wonderful young man.
I understand he was at the Grand Ole Opry and took 3 standing ovations.
You understand correctly, sir.
Last year?
Uh-huh. And he also did the same thing at the World's Fair down in New Orleans. So I think your viewers all across America are in for a real rare treat.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the man of the hour, Mr. Jason Ellsworth, right over here.
Who said I love you till I die? She told him you'll forget in time. As the years went slowly by, she still preyed upon his mind. He kept her picture on his wall.
Jason.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Way to go. My, my. Jason?
Yeah? Thank you.
Jason, I must tell you, you got a standing ovation here at the Gaslight Studio tonight. Welcome to the show. How are you?
Oh, I'm doing pretty good.
Looking forward to the telethon?
Yeah.
You work a lot of telethons?
Well, I've only worked at one. And that was last year in January when I first met Tandy Rice. And I sang a couple of gospel songs, but I goofed up. And
you what?
Goofed up, and so...
How did you goof up?
Didn't practice.
Oh. How did you get an invitation to the White House? That's impressive.
They called, and they told Mom that, I think they told Mom to be at the White House, to sing at the White House with Larry Gatlin and the Gatlin brothers. And
what'd you sing with Larry Gatlin and the Gatlin brothers?
Long Gone Notes and Blues and All the Gold in California.
Oh, okay.
That's one of my songs.
Larry Gatlin told me you were really good.
I know that. Yeah.
Do you have any brothers and sisters?
I have two sisters. One 11, one 16.
I'll tell you what I want you to do. We're going to have to go to a break here. And I want you, as we roll into the break, we always play music as we go to the break. Would you do a little bit of Long Gone Lonesome Blues for me?
Sure.
And you professional musicians, if you can, would you please fall in? Thank you.
Oh.
Go get him, Jason.
Nashville Now, coming up live from Opryland, USA, from America's country home. You're watching the Nashville Network.
Today, young Jason Ellsworth of East Windsor made it, not to Carnegie Hall, but to the Kennedy Center in the nation's capital. Jason is 8 years old, he is blind, he has cerebral palsy, he also plays the piano very well. He's in Washington for the National Very Special Arts Festival, sponsored by the Committee of Arts for the Handicapped. Jason, one of 750 disabled and non-disabled performers representing all 50 states. For Jason's mother, Susan, the day bringing back 8 long years of memories.
I was thinking everything that's gone on in the last 8 years, how far he's come. From 2 pounds when he was born, and the uncertainty of whether he would even survive, to being able to do what he does, and to be able to move the people as he did today.
Young Jason and the rest of the performers spent the past 3 days in Washington attending workshops and performances. The Very Special Arts Festival ends tomorrow.